two charts. One is for Beethoven and the other is for Joan of Arc. We're going to look at Beethoven's Paran, as Starlight does this at a click of a simple button. Whatever we see in the window is selected by these big buttons across the top of the main screen. If we click on one with Will and Text, we're going to get precisely that, and the text we get is selected by the text button. Let's play. So here we have Beethoven's chart and his Paran. A little squashed up, so we'll just resize Beethoven's window so we can see things a little bit more clearly. As we resize the slide bar or panel within the window, we resize the chart. And now we can see his Paran. And you'll notice straight away all the simple meanings of those screens are being listed next to each star. We can get a bigger view of this if we click the big button simply for all text in the window. So now we can see just his Paran. And notice Joan of Arc's chart is still happily sitting there in her window. So here we have Beethoven's Paran, and we can print these out, but first preview them by clicking the preview button. Now we see the page as it would be printed out. We can zoom in on this. If you're happy with this page, you can print it out simply by clicking the print button. Let's go back to the main. So now we can see Beethoven's Paran, and you'll notice they're sorted by the areas in his life, or rather periods of his life. We can change this by changing the way we sort the Paran. Now we can see they are being sorted by the Paran that are connected to each planet. We can change this back to the normal Paran. We'll talk more about those text options in other demonstrations. So here we have Beethoven and